各位弟兄姐妹，大家平安。
Greetings of peace to everybody.
那我们今天晚上要分享的题目是学习形象。
So tonight I'd like to share about learning filial piety.
其实有的时候我们在生活里面发现到，有关于就是不听父母的话，或者是就是欺负父母的事情，在很多的社会上都会发现。
So we often see in society people showing disrespect or disobedience towards their parents.
好，那我们从圣经里面看到说一件事情，就是在末日的这个危险日子来到，就是有一些人会忤逆自己的父母。
So we see from the Bible that in the end times, people will start to disrespect their parents.
好，也就是说，在整个社会的风潮底下，就是这个潮流底下，就是讲到有关于将自己凸显出来。
So the trend of society is going towards the individual, being more individualistic.
好，那变成说对于自己的父母，对于这些长辈，并没有太非常的看重他们。
And so you don't pay as much regard to your parents or your elders.
好，所以我们来看一下保罗在写信给提摩太的时候，他特别吩咐当时候的信徒。
So let us look at what Paul said to the believers at that time when he was writing to Timothy.
好，他特别强调一件事情，就是孩子要在家里面学习行孝、孝顺这件事情。
He mentioned how children need to learn how to be filial.
好。我们来看在这个提摩太前书的第五章第四节。
First Timothy chapter 5 verse 4.
好，要尊敬那真为寡妇的。好，那接下来说，假设说这个寡妇有儿女或有孙子孙女，便叫他们先在自己家中学着行孝，报答亲恩，因为这在神面前是可悦纳的。好，所以从这个经节里面我们看到，
So from this verse we can see.
好，其实保罗特别教导当时的信徒说，你要而这个孙子孙女或者是孩子都要在家里面学习做这件事情。
So the children and the grandchildren had to learn to do this.
好，做这件事情并不是因为说父母对我，不单只是说父母对我有这个恩典。
So it's not because of the grace that the parents have shown them.
好，更重要是因为在神的眼前这是可蒙悦纳的。
But more so that it is pleasing in the sight of God.
所以当个基督徒如果要讨神的喜悦而不是讨自己的喜悦。
So if a Christian wanted to please God rather than themselves.
那在家里面真的要好好听父母的话。
They will need to learn to obey their parents.
神在这个利未记跟生命记里面又再一次的强调。
So it's mentioned again in Leviticus and Deuteronomy.
我们来看一下这两段的经节。
Let's look at these passages.
好，利未记十九章的第三节。
Leviticus chapter 19 verse 3.
好，神把这个孝顺父母跟安息圣日似乎看成相同的重要。
So it seems that God has placed equal emphasis on honoring your parents and Sabbath.
好，在第三节，十九章第三节，利未记十九章第三节。
Leviticus chapter 19 verse 3.
说，你们个人都要当孝信父母，也要守我的安息日，我是耶和华你们的神。神告诉以色列百姓说要当孝敬父母。
So God told the Israelites that they had to honor their parents.
后面讲说也要守安息圣日。
And also keep the Sabbath.
我们怎么守安息圣日呢？我们如何去守安息圣日？
How do we keep the Sabbath?
我们认为说安息圣日它是一个诫命。
So we know that keeping the Sabbath is a commandment.
我们知道说这个日子是要分别为圣归给神的。
This day has to be sanctified for God.
不说自己的实话，不办自己的实事。
We don't say what we want to do and do what we want to do.
不说自己的实话。
So we don't talk about what we want to say.
并且用一个欢心快乐的心，欢喜快乐的心来参加这个安息圣日。
So we come to worship to keep the Sabbath with a joyful heart.
如果把刚刚所上述的所谓的安息圣日换成当孝敬父母呢？
So if we replace the Sabbath with honoring our parents,
我们有没有尊重父母？
Have we respected our parents?
我们有没有看这个是孝敬父母是一个非常重要的事情？
Do we regard this as something important?
我们对于父母的谈话当中，是不是以父母为主？
So do we regard them as more important in our conversations with them?
并且看到孝顺父母是一件非常快乐的事情。
And do we regard this as a joyful matter?
不是重担。
Not a burden.
而是从心里面真的爱着父母。
But loving our parents from our hearts.
当然孝顺的模式都不太一样。
So there are different means to show filial piety.
重点不在于说我怎么去做，而是我有没有愿做的心。
So it's not the means, but whether you have a willing heart.
好，那神怎么样告诉以色列百姓？
What did God tell the Israelites?
其实神的思维里面是说，我有一些规矩。
So it seems like God has some rules.
好，所以我们来看一下，在申命记第五章里面，神有特别再加一句话。
So God added in Deuteronomy chapter 5.
好，这个是在出埃及记第二十章里面没有写到的。
Something that was not mentioned in Exodus 20.
好，申命记的第五章的十六节，五章的第十六节。
Deuteronomy chapter 5 verse 16.
当照耶和华你神所吩咐的孝敬父母。好，前面这句话，当照耶和华你神所吩咐的孝敬父母。
Honor your father and your mother as the Lord your God commanded you.
那神怎么样教导以色列百姓去孝顺自己的父母呢？
And how did God teach the Israelites to honor their parents?
好，我们看到说东西方这个文化当中啊。
So when we look at Western and Eastern culture.
好，我们会发现到说确实有一些不太一样的事情。
We see that there are differences.
好，比如说对于父母的那种尊重的方式。
So, the way that respect is shown to parents.
好，不一定完全都是听父母的话。
Perhaps it's not shown through utter obedience.
好，东方人比较喜欢说，哎，孩子是我生的，所以什么事情就是照着我的规划安排去过生活。
So, if you have an Eastern perspective, then the parents will feel that the child was belongs to them, and they can decide for them their lives.
所以我跟他安排一些这些课外的活动或者一些辅导，啊，他就要去参加了。
And they have to attend the extracurricular activities that you arrange for them.
那可是我们从移民从自己的故乡到了纽西兰这个地方。
But now that we've immigrated from our homeland to New Zealand,
我们还是存留了我们所谓的原本的文化观念。
We hold on to our original cultural concepts.
我们认为说这是好的。
And we think that these are good.
可是我们这孩子从在西方国家长大。
But our children are growing up in Western society.
他们对我们的一些回应似乎没有办法按照我们的预期来做啊。
And perhaps some of their responses are not according to what our expectations are.
所以或许有些人在谈话当中跟我谈说，哎，传道真的有一些些困难。
And so some people have mentioned in their conversation with me the difficulties they've faced.
啊，所谓的听话，所谓的孝顺，好像不一定适用在这个环境里面。
And it seems like obedience or filial piety is not suitable for this environment.
其实东西方文化并没有所谓的好坏优劣之分。
So there is no Eastern and Western culture are no better or worse than one another.
它只是做法不太一样而已。
It's just different ways of doing things.
好，那我们要回到圣经里面看看耶和华所吩咐的。
So let us look back at the Bible at what the Lord had commanded.
好，我们看到说，圣经里面讲到这才是一个重点。
So the Bible emphasized.
好，当我们讲到这个东方国家，我们先来看东方国家哈。
So let us look at Eastern society.
所有的食衣住行娱乐都是由父母安排的。
So parents are the ones who organize your dwelling place, what you eat, what you wear, and what you do.
好，那包括说一个孩子长大将来要去哪里，好，这个工作要做什么职业，父母都还想要干预。
And parents want to play a part or interfere with what the child will do as a job or where they will go.
曾经在网络上面有一则是这样讲的。
So there was a piece of news on the internet.
他说有一个妈妈带着自己的孩子去那个应征，然后去面试。
A mother brought her child to an interview.
那妈妈就在场了。妈妈在场。
So the mother was there.
当那个主考官问问题的时候啊，那个妈妈就抢着回答。
And when the interviewer asked the question, the mother went and answered.
好像是妈妈去做 interview, 不是孩子。
Like the mom was undertaking that interview rather than the child.
那个面试官就问了一些问题。
So the interviewer asked some questions.
妈妈脾气就来了。
And then
妈妈的脾气就来了。
Yeah, and then the mother was angry.
就说这份工作我们不要了，回家我养你。
And said that we won't take this job. Let's go home. I will raise you.
好。那网络上面说，这个是一些面试官遇到的比较非常特别的案例。
So these are some special cases that interviewers have come across.
所以包括将来的结婚对象。
So including marriage partners.
你要跟谁结婚
？So who you should marry?
什么条件 全部开出来。
What requirements they should have.
好，这是我们东方人的思维哦。
So this is an Eastern concept.
但是西方国家倒可不是像我们这样子的。
But Western concepts are not like this.
他们的思维是说，我的责任是养育儿女，到他成人。
According to Western concept, the parent's responsibility is to raise the child until they are mature.
等他成人以后，他能够独立，就让他出去吧。
And once they are mature and they can be independent, you'll send them out.
好，那他要成立家庭，他要在这个社会上面独立起来。
So they have to establish their family and be independent in society.
好，那不一定要住一起，没关系。
You don't need to live together.
好，这个西方国家的三大节期。回来看看就可以了。
And as long as they come to visit on the three big celebrations during the year, that is enough.
不一定要住在同一个屋檐底下。
They don't need to live under the same roof.
如果天天来住在同一个屋檐底下，他还觉得烦呢。
And they might find it annoying if they had to do that.
所以有些人说，我宁可去住安老院。
And so some say they will rather live in a retirement home.
那边有专人的护士、医生来看顾。
And there are specialized nurses and doctors who will take care of them there.
这样子大家有一段距离也不是、哦、也不会互相的干扰。
And so some distance will mean that you won't interfere too much with each other's lives.、
那在东方国家可就不一样了。
So this concept does not exist in Eastern society.、
一定要全家住一起。
So the whole family has to live together.、
父母年老了送到安养院去，父母会说孩子不孝顺，不要我了。
And parents will find that their children are being disrespectful if they were sent to a retirement village when they are old.
那为什么会有这样的观念跟想法？
So why are these concepts and ideas in existence?
东方父母会说，我从小把你拉拔长大，付出了这么多。
So Eastern parents think that I have raised you since young.
所以我爱的越多，权力就越大。
The more love I have shown, the more authority I have over you.
所以有些父母会这样对孩子说啊。
So parents will say to their children,
在我的眼中，你再大都还是我的孩子，我把你当成孩子看，小孩看。
So no matter how great or how old you become, you are still my child.
但是西方国家就不一样了。
But Western concept is different.
他说这个孩子是独立个体。
So they treat the child as an individual.
你应该要独立长大，不要天天依赖我。
Grow up and become independent and not rely on me every day.
能够独立，经济独立，家庭独立，个性独立，那你就出去。
So if you can be financially as well as personally independent, then you can go out.
那当然，在一些东西文化交流当中，有些人也吸收了西方国家的观念。
So Eastern and Western concepts have interacted, and some have absorbed some ideas from the other.
曾经我在注牧期间跟一些弟兄姐妹在谈啊。
So when I was pastoring a church, I had a conversation with some brethren.
他们就说，以现在这个经济情况来看，他们不要伸手跟我要钱，我就很感谢了。
And they said that, considering the economic status at the moment, it's a blessing if they don't ask for money from me.
重点。东西文化各有优缺嘛，只有那我们就是要截长补短，就是好。
So there are pros and cons to Western and Eastern society thinking.
好，那圣经又是怎么教导我们的
？So how does the Bible teach us?
首先，当我们在孝顺父母当中
，When honoring our parents，
我们会不会有压力
？Are we feeling a burden by it？
因为好像是欠父母的债嘛。
It's as if we owe them a debt.
还是我们真的从心里面真的要孝顺我们的父母？
Or do we truly want to honor them from our hearts?
圣经里面告诉我们，这是神所吩咐的。
The Bible tells us that this is a commandment from God.
我愿不愿意讨神的喜悦？
Are you willing to please God?
我不在乎我自己的感受了。
And are you willing to lay aside your own feelings?
如果还是纯粹在回到自己的感受当中的时候，
So if children were to be fixated on their own emotions,
这种事情，这个学习行孝这件事情，就没有办法落实在生活里面。
They won't be able to enact in their lives the lesson of filial piety.
有人就会提出一个意，提出这种想法了。
So some people may say,
如果那个父母是不尽责的父母
，If the parents are irresponsible,
他就有生我，但他并没有养我。
They gave birth to me, but they didn't raise me.
他并没有教育我。
They didn't educate me.
他甚至还有家暴。
They abused me.
那我该不该孝顺他
？Should I still respect them？
就有些人会想出一些比较特殊的案例 来问这个问题了。
So some people may raise these special scenarios.
但是圣经上面说，你愿不愿意看待你的父母，就好像你尊重安息圣日。
But the Bible says that your willingness to honor your parents can be equal to your willingness to obey the Sabbath.
你怎么看待安息圣日的？
So how do you regard the Sabbath?
有时间再来。
If I have time, I'll come.
或者是这天我一定要到。
Or I must be here today on this day.
我们可以回到我们的生活层面来看。
So if we look at our lives,
在这个第一代跟第二代当中，语言文化观念是不一样的。
So the culture and language, there's a culture and language difference between the first and second generation.
所以有些父母会这样教育自己的儿女。
So some parents will educate their children.
如果有长辈在，就不要讲英文，因为我们听不懂啊。
So if there are people older than you here, do not speak English because we cannot understand.
那如果你们私底下想要讲英文，你们就用英文交谈吧。
You can speak in English in private.
那假设说我们不尊重父母，就用英文来交谈，父母实际上根本就听不懂。
So if we don't respect our parents and we choose to speak in English and they don't understand,
请问这个是不是是不是需要去改变的想法？
Is this something that you need to change?
或许有人会说，我中文表达不好啊。
Perhaps some people may say that their Chinese expression is not as good.
我不知道要讲什么啊。
They are not sure what to say.
但是那是一种的态度。
But it's a matter of attitude.
你用简单的中文表达也是可以的，没有需要很深啊。
So it's good enough to express yourself with simple Chinese.
久了以后就会习惯了。
And after a while, you'll become used to it.
所以，我们看看说，这个就是我们要去思考的，就是不是以自己的好来认定很多事情。
So we don't judge matters according to what we think is good.
比如说孩子之间在聊天讲话，有的时候父母想要去知道说他们在聊什么。
So sometimes parents want to know what their children are talking about.
那想要去问，想要去了解。
They want to understand and they will ask about it.
父母会不会对父母那种不耐烦的心，然后这个你也不懂，那个你也不知道。
So will you feel frustrated that your parents don't understand?
所以圣经里面说什么？
What does the Bible say?
他说你孝敬父母。
You have to honor your parents.
他的意思就是你现在主动的去亲近尊重你的父母。
So it means that immediately right now you have to actively go and honor your parents.
我们来看一下以弗所书六章第二节。
Let's turn to Ephesians chapter 6 verse 2.
好，以弗所书六章第二节。
Ephesians chapter 6 verse 2.
好，保罗说，当我们要孝敬父母的时候。
Paul said, honor your father and mother.
他就是说你现在主动的付出去尊重你的父母。
So it means that you need to go and actively show respect to your parents.
不要等到父母离开这个世界的时候，才在那边伤心难过说，早知道我就好好孝顺父母。
So do not wait until you feel sad and regretful when your parents have passed away.
那你怎么，一个孩子怎么样去主动的去孝敬父母，或是让父母得到荣耀？
How does a child actively go and honor their parents and let them be glorified?
他所谓的尊重父母，孝敬父母。
Bring parents honor.
其实他原来的意思就是说，父母在你的心目中啊，他的分量是多少？
Is seen and how highly you regard them.
如果你真的在父母在你的心目中分量是很大的。
So if you regard them highly.
你尊重你的父母，就好像你敬畏天上这位神是一样的。
You honor your parents in the same way that you respect God in heaven.
那么，你可能不敢顶嘴。
Then you wouldn't dare to talk back.
因为是对，如果向神顶嘴、向神抗议，这种的态度不是神所喜悦的。
So God does not like it when we talk back or resist against Him.
那有人就会问哦，那如果父母真的观念是错的，做法是错的？
So some may ask, what if our parents are thinking wrongly or doing something wrong?
他们过去的经验不一定适合现在的生活。
And their past experiences cannot be applied to life now.
甚至有些人会认为说，父母的观念已经违背了圣经了。
Or some may think that their parents' concepts are not biblical.
那我该如何去面对？
What do we do then?
我们来看一下提摩太前书第五章第一节。
Let's turn to 1 Timothy.
五章第一节第二节
Chapter 5 verse 1 and verse 2
在提摩太前书第五章一节到二节保罗就告诉了提摩太你该怎么去面对这样的事情
So in 1 Timothy chapter 5 verse 1 and 2 Paul tells Timothy how they should treat this issue
首先你不可以严责长辈老人家
So firstly you must not rebuke an older person
不能够当众让父母蒙羞让他觉得很丢脸
So you cannot shame your parents
那第二个呢你要劝他们用劝的
So you need to encourage them
所以第二节其实保罗也说你也要用劝的
So it says to encourage them
这个是保罗的一个观念跟想法
So this is Paul's concept
所以父母有的时候不是都是对的
So parents are not always right.
但是我们讲话的态度跟内容很重要。
But our attitude and the content of our speech is important.
同样一句话，如果态度是好的，那父母会去接受的。
So parents may be willing to accept something said with a good attitude.
所以对于神，或者是对于那些神明，你是用什么态度去敬拜他们呢？
So how do you, what kind of attitude do you have when you worship God?
比如说对于一些外邦人他们有的时候就是信奉他们的神的时候是非常的尊敬的。
So people of other religions are very reverent when they worship their gods.
我们今天对于我们天上这位神有没有尊敬?
Do we show equal respect towards our God?
所以圣经里面就提醒我们你怎么样对待神也会相对的怎么样对待你的父母
So you will treat your parents the same way that you treat God
那很重要的事情就是有些事情是该做的
There are some things that we ought to do
但是呢不要假借宗教之名来做这样的事情
But
不好的事情
do not do evil things in the name of religion
我们来看一段圣经这是耶稣提出来的
Let's look at something that Jesus mentioned
马可福音第七章
Mark chapter 7
马可福音第七章这个耶稣提醒当时候的人
So Jesus reminded the people at the time
好我们来看一下第七章第六节
Chapter 7 verse 6
好一直看到十三节
Until verse 13
重点放在哪里
Where's the emphasis
就是他们搞错了是所谓的先后顺序跟轻重缓急
So they had a wrong concept of their priorities
好第六节是这样讲的
Verse 6.
耶稣说以赛亚指着你们假冒为善之人所说的预言是不错的如今上说这百姓用嘴唇尊敬我心却远离我他们将人的吩咐当作道理教导别人所以拜我也是枉然好第一个耶稣引用了以赛亚所讲的这段话
Jesus quoted from Isaiah
他的意思就是说这些人在这个圣殿里面祷告的时候就一直讲赞美神的话尊敬神的话
So the people gave praises to God.
但是有没有真的从心里面赞美神
In the temple, but did they truly worship and praise from their hearts?
借着祭司、先知的这样的教导，有没有进入他们的心呢
So did the teachings God gave to them through the priests and prophets into their hearts?
所以心就远远的离开这位神。
So their hearts were far away from God.
那生活当中人家会教导说你怎么做你怎么做他们就照着别人教导的不是照着神的教导好来做
So they followed what people told them they should do in their lives but they didn't follow God's teachings
所以这边说拜神也是枉然的
So their worship towards God was in vain
变成了这个信仰生活已经变成了一种形式化
So their faith had just becomean outward action.
所以第八节说，你们是离弃死的诫命，然后去守住人的遗传。
Verse 8, you leave the commandment of God and hold to the tradition of men.
第九节又说，你们仍然是废弃神的诫命，要守自己的遗传。
And it says, in verse 9, you have a fine way of rejecting the commandment of God in order to establish your tradition.
那他们的遗传是什么？
What was their tradition?
圣经上说，你当孝敬父母。
The Bible says, honor your parents.
又说咒骂父的必要致死他。
And you have to, whoever reviles mother or father shall surely die.
但回到了文士法利赛人的时候，就说，我们已经做了这个割额板，就是要准备供奉的意思。
But the priests.
啊，第十一节啊。
But the Pharisees said that they had prepared a permit.
好，也就是说，其实儿女可能会留一笔钱，就是说要给父母说，啊，这是给你这个赡养的费用，这是给你生活的费用。
So they had prepared a fund for their parents, for them to live off.
好，然后他们就说，哎，不好意思哦。我已经决定奉献给神了，我已经决定奉献给教会了。
And、then they said that I have decided to donate this fund to the church.
就是所谓的贡献的意思。好，那这个时候呢，既然要给神的，啊，那不好意思哈，那个费用就不给你，生活的费用就不给你了。
So they said that this is going to be for God and no longer for the parents.
好，所以这边十二节说，以后你们就不容他们再奉养父母了。
So verse 12, then you no longer permit him to do anything for his father or mother.
所以十三节说，这就是你们遵守人的这个遗传，但是废了神的道理。
So thus making void the word of God by your tradition.
也就是说，你只要用宗教名义说这是要奉献给神的，这是要奉献给教会的，你就可以不用尽到儿女的责任。
So in the name of religion, they said that they are going to offer this to the church, and in doing so, they no longer honored their parents.
但神告诉我们
，But God told us.
神的物该归给神。然后该撒的物当归给该撒。
So the things that belong to God must go to God, and the things that belong to Caesar go to him.
好，该奉献的十分之一，感恩奉献，这是该给神的。
So we need to give to God tithe and our thanksgiving offerings.
该给父母的那些奉养经费，好，在当时候来讲。也是应该给父母的。
And at that time, they had to give to their parents some money as well.
好，那我们可以看到说，当然在今天的社会当中，不一定要有所谓的赡养费，然后每个地方都不太一样，父母也不一定会拿。
In society now, it is not tradition for us to give. It may not be tradition for us to give money to our parents.
但是那是一种儿女对父母的孝心。
But it is a sign of honoring our parents.
其实，这个就像我们在这个马拉基书第四章第一章里面所看到的奉献的心态。
So this is similar to the attitude and offering mentioned in Malachi chapter 1.
神真的需要这些祭物吗
？Does God need these offerings?
其实神不需要了。
So he doesn't.
但他所要的是什么
？What does he desire?
当你真的要奉献给神的时候，你请你拿上最好的。
When you are going to offer, you should bring your best to him.
不要说瞎眼的、瘸腿的、有病的、用不着的，就给神吧。
So we don't give to God what is blind or useless or lame, or give God that.
好，不要用这样的心态对待神。
So that's not the attitude we should have towards God.
那也不要说用不着的东西，好，或者不想要的东西就给父母。
And we shouldn't give to our parents what we don't need anymore.
不一定是要所谓的昂贵的东西。
So it doesn't need to be something very luxurious.
但是至少是我们诚心实意拿出最好的东西。
But it is something from our hearts that we think is good.
所以这个就是神所要的。
So that is what God desires.
那圣经里面说，这种事情是不是要从家里面开始学习呢
？And the Bible says that this is something that we need to learn from our own families.
我们看到说路德跟拿俄米之间的整个互动。
When we look at the interaction between Naomi and Ruth,
路德对她的婆婆有没有尊敬
？Did Ruth honor her mother-in-law?
有孝顺。
She did.
好，那怎么做呢
？And how does she achieve this?
主动的跟随她的婆婆。
She initiated. And following her mother-in-law.
好，主动的去田里面拾取麦穗。
She actively went out to collect grains from the fields.
当她的婆婆跟她讲说你该怎么做的时候，她就顺着她的婆婆的话去做了。
And when her mother-in-law told her to do something, she obeyed.
所以我们看到说，其实，在教会里面也要主动做一些事情，在家庭里面也是一样的。
So, in church as well as at home, we need to actively do things.
晚辈服侍长辈是理所当然的。
So, it is right for the younger generation to serve the older.
所以教会里面会排一些清洁的工作。
So there are some cleaning duties at church.
所以当我们被排到的时候，其实我们可以主动的去帮忙。
So when we have been rostered, we should be active in doing this duty.
不是等到别人说，哎，今天是某某你某某人该清理。
Rather than wait for somebody to remind us.
所以当我们的心对于神是尊重的。
So if we have a respectful attitude towards God.
当我们对于神的日子是尊重的，圣日是尊重的。
And we respect His holy day.
神说你就用这样子尊重我的态度来尊重你的父母。
God is telling us that we should have the same attitude towards His day, towards our parents.
那有些人会说，如果父母没有尽到自己的责任时，我该孝顺他吗？
So some people may ask whether they still need to show respect to their parents if they do not, if they think their parents don't fulfill their responsibilities.
他对我不好，难道我就要对他好吗？
Do I need to treat them with goodness if they mistreat me?
如果他没有尽到一天做父母的责任，那我长大了还要回去孝顺。
Do I still need to show them filial piety if they have not fulfilled the duty as a parent?
这个就是我们在思想上面的改变。
So, this requires a change in concept.
请问孝顺父母合不合乎真理？
So, is filial piety in accordance to the truth?
如果是真理，是合乎诫命的。
So, if it is truth, if it is a commandment.
有的时候不需要再一次的回到自我的感觉，说我感觉不好。
We don't need to return to our feelings, our uncomfortable feelings.
因为神的诫命总是在挑战人软弱的那一面。
Because the commandments of God often challenge the weaker side of man.
那我们又知道说，只有遵守诫命的人才能够得到永生。
And only those who obey the commandments can obtain eternal life.
好，所以我们来提一个例子来看哈。
So let's look at an example.
好，提摩太前书第五章。
First Timothy chapter 5.
五章八节。
That's it.
好，这边保罗说，人若不看顾亲属，就是背了真道，比不信的人还不好，不看顾自己家里的人更是如此。什么叫做看顾？
What does it mean to provide for our household?
好，其实英文翻得很好。
So the English translation is very apt.
就是供给。就是供养自己的亲属或者父母
，to make provisions for our household，
或者想到自己的父母
，to think about them。
当我赚钱了
，when I am earning money，
当我买东西了
，when I'm buying something，
我没有想到我们的父母
，do we think about our parents？
还是只有想到自己好就可以了
，or do we just think about our own ourselves？
圣经保罗说，你只要有想到你的父母就可以了。
So the Bible says here that as long as you have remembered your parents, it is enough。
当有一天你去吃好吃的东西，记得打电话给父母说要不要一起来吃啊。
So when you are about to go for a good meal, remember to call up your parents to invite them.
当你出去逛街买衣服的时候，打电话问父母说有没有需要新的一件衣服。
And when you are outside shopping, you can call your parents and ask them if they need anything.
当然父母或许不想要花孩子的钱，说哎没关系没关系，我衣服很多，我刚吃饱。
So parents may say that I have just eaten, I have enough clothing.
我们也不一定要买嘛，哦。
So we may not need to purchase anything.
但是至少我们打电话问的那一个动机，就是我真的有想到父母。
But the initial motive, of us calling them is that we have thought of them first.
保罗说，如果你都不会为家人着想，那就是背了真道。连不信人都知道这么做，那你却做不到。
So if anyone does not provide for his relatives, he has denied the faith and is worse than an unbeliever.
所以敬畏的心很重要。
So a heart that honors your parents is important.
当我们在跟一个尊敬的人去讲话的时候
，When we are talking with someone very respectable，
我们对于我们所用的言辞，我们会非常的注意。
We'll be careful about the way we say things.
我们绝对不会是以上对下的骂他、责备他。
We'll not rebuke them from a top to bottom approach.
我们会建议他怎么做。
We may give them suggestions.
那我们看到说，假设有一天父母的想法跟我不一样。
So if one day our opinions clash with our parents.
当然这个环境会塑造不同的这个好不同的世代。
So each environment will create or mold a different generation.
过去的经验不一定适用在现在的生活。
And past experiences may not be applicable to current life.
因为时代一直在变迁，观念一直在改变。
Because concepts change and times change.
好，那该怎么办呢
？So what should we do？
我们来看一下路加福音第二章。
Let's turn to Luke chapter 2.
好，耶稣在圣殿里面待了三天，这件事情并没有跟他父母商量。
Jesus stayed for 3 days in the temple, and he had not discussed with his parents about this.
好，所以他的父母到了第四天，决定说，哎，找不到他，就回到了这个耶路撒冷去找他。
So on the fourth day, when his parents could not find him, they returned to Jerusalem to seek for him.
耶稣的生母玛利亚说：“你看我跟你父亲，然后这样子来找你啊。”
So Mary, the mother of Jesus, went.
伤心的来找你哦，第三四十八节。
So went to Jesus and said that we have come here to look for you.
他的意思是说，你到底做什么？
So she was inquiring what he had done.
你为什么要留在圣殿里面三天不跟我们讲？
Why did you stay?
我们这样伤心的来找你。
Why did you treat us so, and stayed at the temple for 3 days, so that we are in such great distress?
那耶稣怎么回答？
What was Jesus' reply?
他说为什么找我呢？岂不知我当以我的父事为念吗？
Jesus replied, Why are you looking for me? Did you not know that I must be in my father's house?
耶稣有自己的想法。
Jesus had his own ideas.
他说了这话，他父母是不明白的。
He said this and his parents did not understand.
但是耶稣最后又顺着回到了拿撒勒去啊，顺着父母回到拿撒勒去。
Jesus after this, Jesus followed them to Nazareth.
所以这边说，并且顺从他们，就是顺从自己的父母。
And it says here he was submissive to them.
难道耶稣没有想法吗
？So does Jesus not have his own ideas?
他没有自己的价值观吗
？And his own values.
但他还是，就算是父母不懂，他还是尽到身为儿子孝顺的一些。
So he still showed filial piety as a son, even though his parents may not have understood.
好，那第二个，我们看到说，其实有的时候父母如果错得太离谱
，So sometimes when our parents commit a great wrong,
那我们身为儿女的应该去劝劝父母。
We should encourage them as children.
试着去改变他们。
We can try to change them.
我们看到扫罗王追杀大卫。
When Saul sought to kill David.
好，约拿丹知道他父亲所做的是错误的。
Jonathan knew that what his father did was wrong.
他很生气。
He was very angry.
他为大卫讲话。
And he spoke on David's behalf.
好，他有甚至劝自己的父亲不要这么做。
He was encouraging his dad not to do this.
好，所以扫罗记上十九章一到六节里面，我们看到扫罗的观念就改变了。
And we see that Paul changed his mind in 1 Samuel chapter 19.
所以约拿单身为扫罗的儿子。
So Saul's son Jonathan.
所以他看到父亲所做的事情是错的。
Saw that what his father did was wrong.
有的时候气到可能连饭都不吃。
So he was so angry that he was unwilling to eat.
但他并没有直接跟父母对呛。
But he didn't confront his parents immediately.
因为回答柔和的能够使这个怒气消退。
Because he had a gentle way of speaking, he was able to make Saul's anger subside.
好，那我们看到怎么样表现自己的？当我们思想上面改变了，怎么样有好的表现呢？我们要有什么样好的表现
？So what good action should we have?
圣经里面箴言说，不要藐视父母。
So in Proverbs it says, do not despise our parents.
就是不要看轻父母。
Do not look down on them.
时代不一样，有些人比较不会用手机，会请教自己的孩子。
So as times change, the older generation may not be able to use devices as well and will ask their children to help.
那有些年轻的一辈就显出那种不耐烦。
And sometimes you can see frustration in the younger generation.
有的时候对父母所讲的话也是一样显出不耐烦。
And they may also feel frustrated at what their parents have said.
就觉得父母很唠叨，觉得父母总是讲过去的事情。
And they may feel that parents always repeat the same thing.
圣经上面说不要有这样的轻视父母的心态。
So the Bible tells us not to have this despising attitude towards our parents.
那在言语上面呢
？What about in what we say?
好，我们来看一下出埃及记二十一章。
Let's turn to Exodus chapter 21.
好，出埃及记二十一章。
Exodus 21.
在这里，神告诉以色列百姓是你们就绝对不可以骂父母的。
God told the Israelites that they could not rebuke their parents.
我们看十七节。
Verse 17.
咒骂父母的，必要把他治死。
Whoever curses his father or his mother shall be put to death.
圣经里面一直提醒我们这件事。
So the Bible keeps reminding us.
但我们可能不会到咒骂父母这样的程度。
Perhaps we will never curse our parents.
好，可是有的时候，我们在言语上面可能也会，就是显出不耐烦。
But we may show our frustration in what we say.
比如说，我告诉你这么多次了，你都还记不得吗？
So, they may say, I have told you so many times, can you not remember?
或者是说，你懂什么？
Or, what do you know?
对这件事情你懂什么？
What do you know about this issue?
所以言语上面真的是要很注意，对待父母真的是要很注意。
So we need to pay more attention to the way we speak to our parents.
真的不能殴打父母。
So we cannot rebuke them.
打父母。
Or we cannot hit our parents.
那如果父母年老了，也要找一个安定的地方，让他能够住下来。
And when they are old, we need to find somewhere stable for them to live.
或是同住，或者是分开，或是安老院，不一定，就是让他能够有一个安定的生活。
No matter if it's with us or in a retirement home, we need to make sure that they have a stable and peaceful life.
有些人会问说，我孝顺父母，我得到什么好处啊？
So some people may ask, what benefit do I get if I show respect to my parents?
圣经里面，我们刚刚第一翻到的以弗所书第六章第二节所讲的，神会赐福给我们。
So in Ephesians chapter 6 verse 2, it says that God will bless us for it.
其实这个神的赐福就像什么呢？
And what is God's blessing?
它的是福气或者是应许是神所赐的。
So it's a blessing from God.
这个就像意外的惊喜，神秘的小礼物。
And it will be an unexpected gift.
有时候孩子听父母的话。
So sometimes when children listen to their parents.
父母很习惯就是说，当我看到好吃的，我可能就顺便买回来，让孩子吃。
The parents may bring, when they see something that the child would like to eat, they'll bring it back for them.
这个是父母去决定的。
So this is what the parents can decide.
所以当我们提到说神会赐福气给我们的时候，
When we talk about God bestowing blessings,
我们不要再想到说神会怎么赐福给我，他在生活当中来祝福我。
So let us not dwell on how God is going to bless us in our lives.
把这件事情留给神。
We leave that decision up to God.
这样子我们才会得到意外的惊喜。
And that's when we will receive an unexpected gift.
要不然我们会变成一种对等互换的一个概念。
Otherwise, it will be more like a transaction.
我对父母好，神要在我什么方面祝福我。
So I'm going to treat my parents well, and then I will expect God to treat me well in some other way.
那神不祝福我，我就很难过。
And I will be upset if God does not bless me.
那我们想到比较生活层面的。
When we look at our lives.
其实圣经里面箴言23章25节。
So in Proverbs 23 verse 25.
他告诉我们说，身为一个儿女，所要的就是要让父母得到开心。
So it says here, let your father and mother be glad.
让你父母得到开心的时候，父母在生活当中总是会比较疼那些听话的孩子。
So if they are glad, they will love you more.
那我们身为一个年轻人还没有结婚之前。
So as unmarried youth.
当我们真的有一颗孝顺父母的心。
When we are truly honoring our parents.
但不是妈宝。
And we are not being.
他不就是什么事情都听父母的话。
So we are not entirely obedient to them.
有自己的想法。
We do have our own thoughts.
那人家会打听，会去相处。
So other people.
结婚之前都会这么做嘛。
So before you're married, people will want to hear about you. And you interact with you.
那很多人的条件不是就是我要选的那个会孝顺父母的吗？
And some people may have a requirement. They want to marry somebody who can honor their parents.
不一定要有钱。
They may not have to be rich.
那第二个就是说，如果你是已婚者，
So if you are already married,
你孝顺你自己的双方父母，
And if you honor parents of both sides,
其实可以让这个家庭更加快乐。
You will bring more happiness to the family.
如果是一位说，你今天做媳妇的要好好孝顺婆婆，但是我做外子的，我不需要孝顺自己的岳父岳母。
So if the expectation is that the daughter-in-law must honor her in-laws, but the son-in-law does not.
那被要求的那一方心里面就会不平衡。
than the one that has the requirement placed on them will not feel comfortable.
为什么我就得孝顺那曾经没有对我有恩的父母啊？
So why is it that there's only expectation on me to honor these parents who did not raise me?
我没有拿过他一分钱，吃过他一顿饭。
So I have not taken any money from them.
就要像儿女一样孝顺这个父母，对我来讲太困难。
But I need to honor them as if they are my parents. This is too difficult for me.
如果双方都真的很孝顺对方的自己的父母跟对方的父母
，But if both parties can honor parents on both sides,
那这个心态就会平衡了。
Then they will all feel at peace.
那如果说我们今天已经生了小孩了
，If we have already given birth to children,
我们的环境是说我们跟父母同住。
And our situation is that we are living with our parents.
或者是说住在附近。
Or we live nearby.
如果我们真的对我们的父母好。
If we treat our parents well.
嘘寒问暖。
And we treat them warmly.
小孩子会看在眼里。
Our children will see this.
他会看到说，原来我的父母亲是如何孝顺我的这个外公外婆爷爷奶奶。
So they will see how their parents treat their grandparents.
原来这就是所谓的孝顺。
And they will learn what being filial is.
那或许他将来会用相同的态度来对待。
And they will learn to treat us with the same attitude.
所以有一个小故事这样讲。
So there is a story that goes.
他说日本以前有一些时代，他是要把年老的父母背到山上丢掉。
So there was a time when people will carry their parents up to the mountains to discard them.
那有些父母身体强壮的也会自己到山上。
And some more healthy parents will walk up the mountain themselves.
所以有一个儿子就认为说父母老了只会吃饭不会做事，把他背到山上吧。
So there was a son who felt that his parents were old and could only eat and do nothing. So he decided to take them up to the mountain.
所以他就开始编一个比较大的竹篓，要把父母他的母亲放在这个竹篓里面带到山上。
So he started to weave.Some kind of vehicle to bring the mother up.
那个儿子看到他爸爸在做，他也想学着做。
So his son saw that his father was doing this and wanted to learn.
那儿子爸爸就问儿子说：“你做那个干嘛？”
So the father asked the son why he was doing this.
他说：“等你老了，我也是这样待你，对待你。”
He said that I'm preparing this for when you are old.
等你老了，我也会把你背到山上丢在你。丢在山上。
So when you are old, I will carry you up to the mountain to leave you there.
所以孩子是不是在看我们如何孝顺父母？
So our children are watching us and seeing how we honor our parents.
所以我们可以看到说，当一个人孝顺父母的时候，
So when somebody honors their parents,
神会给那孝顺父母的祝福。
God will bless them.
约瑟是个孝顺的孩子。
Joseph was a filial child.
神不断地提升他在社会上面的地位。
And God keep lifting him up in society.
拉合跟路德，他们原本是外邦人。
So Rahab and Ruth were Gentiles.
只因为他们愿意站在神这边。
But because they were willing to stand on God's side.
想到他们的父母。
And they thought about their parents.
他们进入到了这个救恩里面。
They entered into the salvation.
那讲到将来。
When we talk about the future.
耶稣在马太福音19:16-19里面讲的这段话。
In Matthew chapter 19:16-19.
少年官问说：“我当做什么才可以得到永生？”
So the rich young man asked God what he should do to obtain eternal life.
耶稣说，诫命你是知道的。
Jesus said that you know the commandments.
其中一条就是孝顺父母。
And one of them is to honor your father and mother.
你若要进入永生，就必须遵守诫命。
So if you want to enter into eternal life, you need to keep the commandments.
所以孝顺父母重不重要？
It's important to honor our parents.
照着神的诫命所吩咐去做。
So we should act according to what God has commanded.
尊敬我们地上的父亲，如同我们尊敬天上的父亲。
We should honor our earthly parents as we honor our heavenly Father.
我们如何尊敬自己的父母，孝顺他们
？However, we honor our parents.
其实神都在看。
Will be observed by God.
神会祝福我们。
And He will bless us accordingly.
其实不在于文化的差别。
So it is not an issue of cultural differences.
而在于圣经怎么教导。
But how the Bible teaches us.
言语上面不能够辱骂父母，不可咒骂父母。
In our speech, we cannot rebuke or curse our parents.
我们在心态当中不能够轻看父母。
So in our attitude, we cannot despise them.
不能说等到父母年老的时候，老人痴呆了，我就把他丢着。
And we cannot discard of them when they are old.
在这个行为表现里面
So in our actions
就是耐着性子听父母讲话也是另外一种的孝顺
We can also show filial piety by patiently listening to what they have to say
其实父母要的不多啦
So parents don't require much
只是一种的尊重
It is just, just our respect
好所以我们看到我们真的要重新思考圣经如何教导学习行孝
So let us think again about what the Bible teaches us regarding filial piety.
好那这样子在整个教会的气氛在家庭的气氛就会改变。
And if we do this, the atmosphere in the church as well as at home will change.